So hey everyone, I'm Avinash Rao. I work with Cognizant. I'm here to present a case study. We call it the double helix model for lean agile. It's what we're doing with a large project, 70 people, where we're moving from waterfall to a agile lean model. And basically what I want to cover is, we'll start off with a few war stories, and then some of these war stories really will give you a sense of the thinking that has gone behind what we are trying to accomplish in the project, the perspective that we are coming in with. Then we talk a little bit about how we've implemented Lean Agile, and then we look at the double helix model and the results and the reflections that have come as a result of this model. Okay, so those who were in Scrum Bangalore 2 weeks ago have heard this story, so apologies, but I think it really makes the point that I want to. So I'm a Taekwondo green belt, and I started learning 3 years ago, and in London I went in into my Taekwondo class for the first time, and there were two of us who were the real oldies in the group, meaning we were over 30, because everyone else was in college or in high school. And so my sparring partner on day one was a motorcycle mechanic. He had, this guy's black hair, but he looked a little bit like that, but he had blonde hair, a blonde ponytail, and he was this much taller, biceps, tattoos all over. And so the Taekwondo instructor comes in and says, Avinash, now throw Ian on the floor. Ian's going to try and choke you. What you need to do is extricate yourself and throw Ian on the floor. Simple, right? You have 15 minutes. And so I spent the next 15 minutes like this, and I couldn't move him. He was clearly heavier. He was clearly stronger than I was. And there's just no way that I could extricate myself, forget, throw this guy on the floor, right? So 15 minutes later, the instructor decides that I've had enough. And he comes over and he says, you know what you need to do? There aren't any muscles here. So everybody, so what you need to do is he has your hands here, pinch, twist, trip, and he'll fall down. And 30 minutes later, that's exactly what I was doing. So the point I'm trying to make here is that some of the challenges that face us are hard work problems. We can work very hard, and we can, go to the gym for 2 years, and hopefully, after that, we might be able to move this problem. But a much better way to solve these problems are using techniques. And techniques give us results which are much better, much faster, for a certain type of problem. And I think too much of